Let us now study about the prevertebral fascia. We'll talk about the horizontal extent of the prevertebral fascia.
So this is the prevertebral fascia.
Prevertebral fascia. Pre means in front of vertebra. Which vertebra? In front of the cervical vertebra, a fascia which is extending transversely. That is the prevertebral fascia, which is the transverse extent of the prevertebral fascia. So from where it is arising? It is arising from the investing layer of deep cervical fascia under cover of sternocleidomastoid muscle. So after arising from the investing layer under cover of sternocleidomastoid muscle, the fascia passes on either sides medially, forming the posterior wall of the carotid sheath. Forming the posterior wall of this carotid sheath, then further passes medially on either sides to meet with the similar fascia of the opposite side behind the pharynx or behind the esophagus. So this is the horizontal extent of the prevertebral fascia. This prevertebral fascia is giving an offshoot, or it is giving a process. This is a process on either sides which passes or which covers the muscles like scalenus anterior muscle, scalenus medius posterior, scalenus posterior muscle, and this one levator scapulae muscle, semispinalis capitis and splenius capitis muscle. So this prevertebral fascia, that offshoot or the process, covers this muscle and ends under cover of the trapezius muscle. And it is lost under cover of the trapezius muscle. So this part of the facial process, or this part of the prevertebral fascia, is forming the floor of the posterior triangle. So this is the posterior triangular region, posterior triangle region. The roof is formed by the investing layer. The floor is formed by this prevertebral fascia. In fact, the muscles, these are the muscles which are forming the floor of this posterior triangle. All the muscles like the semispinalis capitis, splenius capitis, levator scapulae, scalenus posterior, scalenus anterior are the muscles which are forming the floor of the posterior triangle. They are carpeted by the prevertebral fascia. Okay. So the cervical plexus and the brachial plexus lies between scalenus anterior and scalenus medius muscle. The cutaneous branches of the cervical plexus pierce this fascia and becomes cutaneous. Four cutaneous branches of the cervical plexus like lesser occipital nerve, greater auricular nerve, transverse cervical nerve of the neck and supraclavicular nerves. These are the four cutaneous branches of the cervical plexus. They arise from here between these two muscles. They pierce the fascia and becomes cutaneous. Not only this portion of the prevertebral fascia between these two muscles, the scalenus anterior and medius muscle, forms an elongation. It forms a tubular sheath around the subclavian artery, which passes towards the axilla as a sheath, and that is called as the axillary sheath. So axillary sheath is derived from this fascia, which is the prevertebral fascia between these two muscles, as a tubular prolongation. So this is all about the prevertebral fascia transverse extent. Now coming to the vertical extent of the prevertebral fascia. So this is the base of the skull. To be frank, it is a sphenoid bone. So this is the base of the skull, forming the sphenoid bone. So from the base of the skull, the prevertebral fascia extends. This is the prevertebral fascia which is extending from the base of the skull, and immediately it gives off a branch in front. It divides into two. This is the anterior one and this is the posterior one. So this posterior layer lies in front of this posterior layer lies in front of cervical vertebra. This is first cervical C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, T1, T2 and T3. So these cervical vertebra, in front of the bodies of the cervical vertebra, there is a anterior longitudinal ligament connecting the bodies of adjacent cervical vertebra. So this one is the anterior longitudinal ligament. So this posterior layer blends with the anterior, covers the anterior longitudinal ligament of the upper complete cervical vertebra and finally blends with the anterior longitudinal ligament of T3 or sometimes T4. Finally it blends with the anterior longitudinal ligament of covering the T3 or sometimes the T4. So this is the posterior layer of the prevertebral fascia, whereas this anterior layer, it is called as alar fascia. Anterior layer is called alar fascia. This fascia blends with another fascia called buccopharyngeal fascia or buccopharyngeal membrane. This fascia, anterior layer is alar fascia, it blends with the buccopharyngeal fascia, which covers the constrictor muscles of pharynx, that is which covers the constrictor muscles of the pharynx. This is the medial raphe of the pharynx. So we have superior constrictor muscle, this is middle constrictor muscle and inferior constrictor muscle. And finally this one is the esophagus. So superior constrictor, middle constrictor and inferior constrictor, and this one is the median raphe of it. So this buccopharyngeal membrane covers the superior, middle and inferior constrictor muscle of the pharynx, and this alar membrane, alar fascia, blends with this buccopharyngeal fascia covering this constrictor muscles of the pharynx, and the space between these two space is retropharyngeal space. This is a retropharyngeal space containing pharyngeal plexus of nerves and some vessels and fat. So this space, when it is infected, this space or retropharyngeal abscess where it happens, it may compress the pharynx in front, and this extension of that pus may extend to this portion like this. So this is a prevertebral fascia in front. So when retropharyngeal abscess happens, the bulging may be seen towards the visceral compartment like this. The abscess, the pus may extend anteriorly. So this is in brief about the topic prevertebral fascia. Thank you.